here now to discuss the economic impact art museums have suffered in the past year due to COVID, as well as the celebration of the 700th anniversary of Italian poet Dante's death. Is art historian and author of How Catholic Art Saved the Faith, Dr. Elizabeth Lev. She's joining us from Rome. Liz, thanks for being with us. I want to begin with the Vatican Museums, which just reopened after being shut down for nearly 3 months. This was the second time the museum closed. In a normal year, nearly 7 million people would have visited. In 2020, only 1.3 million walked through the doors. What has been the economic impact on the museum and the Vatican itself?
Well, the economic impact of the closings for the pandemic have been truly terrible. They've been devastating for what is 13.2% of the GDP of Italy, let alone Vatican City State. I was at the Vatican Museums on 2 days ago after 88 days of being closed. 88 days, that is longer than it's been closed since the Second World War. So it was truly a very extensive period. And I have to say that there's still nobody there. So if you can imagine, in many ways, the Vatican Museums have been the economic, you know, power that helped to fund everything in the Vatican. And now there's nothing coming in, barely enough to keep afloat the immense number of custodians, restorers, and people who work there.
Wow. What's the experience like now for visitors? I mean, is this the moment to rush to see the Sistine Chapel without crowds, Liz?
Well, I have to say the experience of those of us who are here and able to be here, it is extraordinary. I was, again, in the Vatican Museums on Tuesday and wandered from room to room all by myself. It felt like I had the museums to myself. And I saw, you know, a few people here and there who just, they walk around like Alice in Wonderland. Like, I can't believe this place is all to myself. So not to make your viewers jealous, but hey, there is a teeny, teeny, teeny little ray for a few of us who are fortunate enough to be able to go to all of these museums. Everything has really got this sense of discovery and specialness.
I want to move on to the great Italian poet Dante. As we mentioned earlier, Italy will celebrate his 700th anniversary throughout the year. Most notably, 88 rarely seen drawings will be on display at the Uffizi Gallery. Now, these are pencil and ink arts from the 16th century. They were drawn by Federico Zuccari. Alongside each drawing is a corresponding verse from Dante's Inferno. Tell us what people will be seeing here and how this art complements Dante's work.
I think it's a really amazing idea on the part of the Uffizi to make these available as a virtual exposition, so people can see it without having to worry about coming to Italy. And so these drawings are online. They've been online since January 8th, and they are amazingly high resolution. These drawings, these 88 drawings by Zuccari, have never been put on display all together. They were done once, I think, in the 19th century, and then again in 1993. But now, even those exhibitions were partial. So this is a chance to really go through. It's a wonderful way for people to really approach the Divine Comedy by seeing the illustrations next to the poem itself, because the poem had such an impact on art. Giotto, Michelangelo, Gustave Moreau, I mean, so many people have really engaged that amazing story.
My only frame of reference for Zuccari is the Palazzo Zuccari with those big monster faces in the doors and the windows. So I'm learning a lot here, Liz. Before I let you go, what is the role of art in preserving a culture, particularly at this moment when humanity itself is boxed away and hidden?
I think Dante is really the answer to that question. Dante wrote the Divine Comedy, these three poems, an epic poem, to after Homer, after Virgil. Dante tells us the great Christian epic of salvation. And he wrote this poem in exile, while he was in exile for 20 years, trying to draw together a fractured peninsula, but in order around a language, around beauty. And so the way that Dante is like our Shakespeare, is what he's to Italy is what Shakespeare is to English. He draws together a beauty of a language, a magnificence of a human story, trying to bring peace, even though he was a first person victim, if you will, of the political unrest of his age. And I think that's when we find the idea that beauty really can save and beauty really can heal. And that is a role the art should play.
Boy, we needed to hear that today. Liz Lev, thank you. Liz is the author of How Catholic Art Saved the Faith. It's available at bookstores everywhere, online, and at the EWTN Religious Catalog. Liz, thank you again.
Thank you very much.